Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Good morning, students. In this session, we are going to discuss how to formation of coordination compound based on the VBT theory. You know that very well, valence bond theory. In my previous session, already I completed the complete information regarding to VBT theory, the postulates and drawbacks of the VBT theory. So in this session, we are going to discuss based on the VBT theory, how to formation of the coordination compounds, how to formation of the coordination compound. Now see, that's why the topic of this session, structure and shapes of some coordination compounds on the basis of valence bond theory. So this is the most important part in board level and also NEET level. So definitely, my dear students, every students watch very carefully. So see, first of all, according to VBT theory, you know that very well, rules and regulations of the VBT theory. What are the rules and regulations of VBT theory? Central metal atom compulsory to provided the vacant orbital and ligands ready to donated the lone pair of electron. First point. Upon my second point, if central atom not provided sufficient vacant orbital, it must be involved in the hybridization. Then the ligand approaching to the central metal atom, hence to form the coordination covalent bond. This is a second important point. So if in case of central metal atom, there is no sufficient orbital, definitely is involved in the hybridization, hence to form new hybrid orbital. So these are the basic important postulates regarding to the VBT theory. You know, in VBT theory, my dear students, the most important point is non-bonding electrons are not involved in the hybridization. Already this kind of all points are clearly explained in my previous session, VBT theory. Now see, according to the VBT theory, how to form coordination covalent bond structures and shapes. So first one, already you know that very well, if coordination number 2 is there, it's a linear manner. Coordination number 3 is there, is a trigonal planar. Coordination number 4 is there, is a tetrahedral manner. And coordination number 5 is there, trigonal bipyramidal manner. And coordination number 6 is there, it's a octahedral manner. Now in this session, based on VBT theory, how to form octahedral complexes? Because of CBSE board point of view, only octahedral complexes formation is most important. So that's why now we are going to start how to formation of the octahedral complexes of based on the VBT theory. You know that very well, octahedral manner means definitely 6 ligands are present here. 6 ligands are present in the coordination compound. That's why the coordination compound coordination number is the 6. Okay, Nana? Now, in VBT theory, how to form octahedral complexes? See here carefully. Octahedral complexes. The octahedral complexes are formed either by D2SP3 hybridization or SP3D2 hybridization. My dear student, the most important key point, if any one of the coordination compound can be existed octahedral complexes, maybe you should follow either D2SP3 hybridization. It means some molecules or some complexes form octahedral shape through D2SP3 hybridization or SP3D2 hybridization. Okay, either D2SP3 hybridization through form octahedral complexes, or sp3d2 hybridization through form the octahedral complexes. That's why, my dear student, the octahedral complexes are formed either by d2sp3 hybridization or sp3d2 hybridization, and can be grouped in the following two categories. Already I said very clearly, if any one of the coordination compounds formed octahedral manner, it should be follow the two hybridization. Number one, D2-SP3 hybridization. Number two, SP3-D2 hybridization. When the complex compounds are involved in the D2-SP3 hybridization or SP3-D2 hybridization. That's why it's split into two categories. So first of all, if central metal atom, listen, very important key point, if central metal atom inner orbital are involved in the hybridization, inner orbital are involved in the hybridization of the complexes, that is called D2-SP3 hybridization. For example, Nana, central metal atom has two different type of orbital, inner orbital or outer orbital. If inner orbital are involved in the hybridization, that kind of hybridization is called D2-SP3 hybridization. If outer orbital are involved in the hybridization from the central metal atom, that hybridization is called SP3-D2. Either inner orbital involved hybridization or outer orbital involved hybridization, definitely to form octahedral complexes. Octahedral complexes. What situation to demand the central metal atom involved in the inner orbital or central metal atom involved in the outer orbital? Now we are going to clearly to be explained. Okay, Nana? The first of all, inner orbital complexes. If in case of the central metal atom, inner orbital are involved in the hybridization, or what kind of hybridizations are existed, D2-SP3. See carefully, inner orbital complexes. The complexes involving D2-SP3 hybridization. D2-SP3 hybridization means 2d orbital, 1s orbital, p3 orbital, or intermixing. See, Nana, one 2d orbital from the central metal atom, one s orbital from the central metal atom, 3p orbital from the central metal atom, intermixing, then to form new hybrid orbital. That is called D2-SP3 hybridization. And similarly, sir, here both of them is same, sir, D2-SP3, SP3-D2. But here, in this case, D2-SP3 case, first d orbital involved in the hybridization. That's why this hybridization name is the D2-SP3. But in this hybridization, first s orbital involved in the hybridization. But both of them has same category. So d2 orbital, d2 orbital, p3 orbital, p3 orbital, s orbital, s orbital. But in this case, in case of the central metal atom inner orbital are involved, first involved in the d orbital. That's why whenever central metal atom inner orbital are involved in the hybridization, that hybridization name is the D2-SP3 hybridization. So once again, my dear students, see carefully, the complexes involving D2-SP3 hybridization are referred to as a inner orbital complexes. This is the most important neat bit, Nana. For example, one central atom involved in the D2-SP3 hybridization, what kind of orbital are involved in the hybridization? Inner orbitals are involved in the hybridization. So if any one of the octahedral complexes are involved in the D2-SP3 hybridization, definitely inner orbital only to participated in this hybridization. Keep it in your mind. Next one. This is because the formation of the such complexes involving the participations of inner d orbital, especially Nana, n-1 d orbital are involved. D orbital is involved, especially in D2-SP3. I told you, first d orbital are involved in this hybridization. So what kind of the d orbital? N-1 category. You know that very well. Last shell is the N shell. Last before shell is the N-1 shell. Last shell name enna? Ultimate shell. Before the last shell, penalty made shell. So n minus 1 is represented penalty made shell. It means last before shell d orbitals only involved in the hybridization. That's why, my dear student, inner orbital complexes means what kind of the d orbitals are involved? You know that very well, my dear student. The d orbital present in the last shell, last before shell, and before shell also. But especially in inner orbital complexes, last before shell, it's nothing but penultimate shell d orbitals only involved in the hybridization from the central metal atom. So once again, see nana this statement, inner orbital complexes. The complexes involving d2sp3 hybridization are referred to as a inner orbital complexes. This is because the formation of such complexes involve the participation of the inner d orbital, such that as n minus 1 d orbital of the central metal atom during the hybridization. So in the during the hybridization, n minus 1 d orbitals only involved. These complexes usually contain lesser number of unpaired electrons. So these complexes usually contain lesser number of the unpaired electron. Most important, nana, if any one of the complex compounds are involved in the inner orbital complexes, lesser number of the unpaired electrons are involved. Therefore, they are also called low spin complexes or spin paired complexes. Which are the low spin complexes? Inner orbital is involved in the hybridization, that is called low spin complexes or spin paired complex. Keep it in your mind, nana. If any one of the complex involved in the d2sp3 hybridization, that is commonly low spin complexes and spin paired complexes. And if any one of the complex involved in the d2sp3 hybridization, inner orbital only involved. Inner orbitals only involved, especially n minus 1 d orbital. N minus 1 d orbital. This is the first part of the octahedral complex. Already I clearly explained, octahedral complexes based on the VBT theory formation, two different type of the hybridizations are showing. Number one, d2sp3, it's nothing but inner orbital only involved in this hybridization. Number two is the sp3d2 hybridization. Now outer orbitals are involved in the hybridization. Now see nana, outer orbital, already completed inner orbital complexes. If any one of the compound involved in the inner orbital, that is d2sp3 hybridization, that complex name is inner orbital complexes. Here n minus 1 d orbital are involved in the hybridization, and moreover, last and final point, low spin complexes, that is called low spin complexes. The best examples are, see here, hexacyanoferrate 4 and hexacyanocobalt 3 and triamine platinum 4. Triamine platinum 4. These are the best examples of, my dear student, from the inner complexes compounds. Hexacyanoferrate 4, hexaamine cobalt 3 plus, hexaamine platinum 4. These are the best examples from octahedral complexes into D2SP3 hybridization. Now one more part, outer orbital complexes. In case of outer orbital involved in the hybridization from the central metal atom to form octahedral complexes. So in this outer orbital complexes, here sp3d2 hybridization is possible. So if outer orbital are involved in the hybridization, that hybridization name is the sp3d2 hybridization, or called outer orbital complexes. See carefully, the complexes which involve sp3d2 hybridizations are called outer orbital complexes. This is because they involve the participation of outer d orbital, nd orbital. In inner orbital na last before shell involved. In the nd orbital na ultimate shell, last shell d orbital. See, outer orbital complexes means in central metal atom, last shell d orbital are involved. Inner orbital complexes means in central metal atom, last before shells is involved. Last before shells is involved. So that's why, my dear students, in outer orbital complexes, nd orbital of the central metal atoms are involved in the during of the hybridization. Such complexes possess comparatively higher number of unpaired electrons. This is the most important, Anna. If any one of the central metal atom involved in the hybridization in outer orbital, definitely the outer orbital contains higher number of the unpaired electron. So in outer orbital involved in the complexes, higher number of unpaired electron, but inner orbital involved in the complexes, low number of the unpaired electrons are involved. So that most important point, Nana. Once again, outer orbital complexes, sp3d2 hybridizations are involved, and moreover, nd orbital of central metal atom. Nd orbital means last orbital of last shell of the d orbital are involved. And moreover, if any one of the central metal atom involved in the outermost orbital, definitely that orbital contains higher number of the unpaired electron. Therefore, they referred as higher spin complexes. So if any one of the complexes are involved in the outer orbital complexes, that is called higher spin complexes. If any one of the complexes involved in the inner orbital complexes, that is called spin, low spin complexes. For example, FeCN6 taken 4 minus, it is a low spin complexes. That is the most important, Anna. Hexacyanoferrate 4 and hexaamine cobalt 3, these all coordination compounds are generally low spin complexes because of the inner orbital are involved in the hybridization. Inner orbital are involved in the hybridization. See down, hexa aqua ion 2 plus, hexa aqua ion 2 plus, and hexa fluoro cobalt 3 minus, and hexa aqua chromium 2 plus, and hexa amine zinc 2 plus. This all compounds are octahedral manner, but the higher spin complexes are nothing but spin free complexes. Higher spin complexes or spin free complexes. It's clear, Nana. These are the major important points regarding to octahedral complexes based on the formation of VBT theory. So my dear students, Linus Pauling are clearly to suggested, if any one of the coordination compound contains six coordination number, it show two different type of hybridization. Number one is the d2 sp3 hybridization, number two is the sp3 d2 hybridization. If d2 sp3 hybridization, that is called inner orbital complexes, and sp3 d2 hybridization, that is outer orbital complexes. Inner orbital complexes lo n minus 1 d orbital are involved, outer orbital complexes lo nd orbitals are involved. This is the low spin complexes and spin paired complexes, or this one is a higher spin complexes and spin free complexes. It's clear, Nana. This is a two basic points whenever to form the octahedral complexes based on the VBT. Now EBT. Now see, Nana. Now we are going to discuss how to form complexes from the octahedral. So now we are going to discuss some important examples from the CBSE test book. So the first example is, see here, first example, hexacyanoferrate 4. How to formation of hexacyanoferrate 4 based on the VBT theory. This is a 4 marks question. My dear students, every student to write regarding to this question information like this one. The same pattern you should be followed. Don't write your own pattern. So now, right now question is, how to form the hexacyanoferrate 2 ion? How to form the hexacyanoferrate 2 ion? Explain based on the VBT theory. Now see here, Nana. here how to express this one. In this compound, listen carefully, most important points is there here. In this compound, the oxidation state of the iron in this complex plus 2, the listen carefully, central metal atom oxidation state is a plus 2. Therefore, iron is present in the form central Fe2 plus ions. Okay, na? So here, in this complex, iron oxidation state plus 2, the plus to the iron oxidation state. Okay, keep it in your mind. Now see here how to simplify to write the complexes of this compound. Clearly observe nana. Idi iron atom da. Iron atom electronic configuration ungalku theriyum. What is the iron electronic configuration in ground state? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6 and 3d6, 4s2. So now I written here last valence, last 3 orbital. So 3d6, 4s2 and additionally 4p orbitals also there. This is the electronic configurations of the iron. This is the last electronic configuration. 3d orbital, 4s and 4p. 3d means 6 electrons are present in the 3d orbital and 4s 2. So that's why, my dear students, what is the electronic configuration of the, what is the electronic configuration of iron? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d, 3s2, 3p6, 3d6, 4s2. The. So now here, say carefully listen. In this complex formation, my dear student, the oxidation state of the iron is the plus 2. The. So plus 2. So here, how many ligands approaching to the iron? 6 ligands are attached to the central metal atom. The coordination number of the iron is a 6. Yes or no? Because of 6 ligands are approaching to the central metal atom. The central metal atom coordination number is the 6. So each CN group or each CN ligand contributed 2 electron and 1 negative charge to central Fe2+. Therefore, the total number of electrons around the iron nucleus 26 minus 2 the. 26 minus 2 plus 12. Total 36 electrons are present in the iron. After combinations of the central metal atom of the cyanide. Already clearly explained in previous session how to EAN number, effective atomic number. Effective atomic number already clearly explained. So after formations of this compound, iron contain 36 electrons. So that's why the total complex's net charge is the minus 4. Total complex net charge is the minus 4. Now once again see nana, Fe plus 2 oxidation state, 6 ligands approaching to the Fe, 6 ligands approaching to the Fe, the total number of the electron oppo, the total number of the electron on the central metal atom 36. So how to calculate the total number of the electron after formation of the coordination compound through EAN number. Okay na, see carefully. First one. This is the iron atomic number 3d6, 4s2, 4p orbital are empty. Ipoh, Fe plus 2, already said iron oxidation state is a plus 2. Plus 2 means from 4s orbital, these 2 electrons are eliminated. See carefully. There is no remaining, difference in remaining orbital. Here 6 electrons already there, here 4s. 4s is deleted because of the 2 electron loses. Aparama, see, this is the most important. Fe plus 2 under the influence of strong ligand. Ipo, see, actually in iron, Fe plus 2, how many unpaired orbital or vacant orbitals are there? How many vacant orbitals are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Only 4. Vacant orbital. But here, how many ligands are approaching to the iron? 6 ligands. So, 2 vacant orbitals are absent. So, upon NIHE, the iron involved in the hybridization. Iron involved in the hybridization. Already this point are clearly explained. See, nana, iron atomic number, this is the iron atomic number. Here, p orbital, 4p orbital, 3 vacant orbitals are there. Aparama in Fe plus 2, this 2 electron is eliminated, one more vacant orbital is formed. So totally 4 vacant orbitals are there. But how many ligands are approaching to the central metal atom? 6 ligands. It means the 6 ligands required 6 vacant orbital. But now here only 4. Apo the central metal atom involved in the hybridization. So now see here in the 3D orbital, 4 unpaired electrons irukana. This 4 unpaired electron mixing together. Mixing together na, this electron jump to here, this electron jump to here. Apo 2 vacant orbital are formed from the 3D orbital. From the 3D orbital, intermixing or sharing of the electron, hence it's creating 2 orbital. So appo enna aachi inga 2 orbital, here one more orbital, here 3 orbital. Total how many orbital? 1 2 3 4 5 6. So here ion under the influence of strong ligand involved in the intermixing of the unpaired electron, hence it's created new vacant orbital. Now how many vacant orbitals are present right now? 1 2 from the d orbital, s orbital 1 from the p orbital 3. These 3 unpaired electrons present in the ground state of the ion. Aparama enna aichi this 3 ground state, this 6 ground state orbital is enna, this 6 ground state orbital, after that intermixing of the orbital, this 6 one is intermixing, it's nothing but involved in the hybridization. இப்போ உங்களுக்கு சயனைடு CN6 இருக்கு, பட் த ஐரன் அரேஞ்சு த 6 ஆர்பிட்டல், பட் திஸ் இஸ் த பியூர் ஆர்பிட்டல். ஆஃப்டர் தட் வி வாண்ட் தி 6 ஆர்பிட்டல் செப்பரேட்டட், ஹென்ஸ் தே ஆர் இன் இட்ஸ் இன்வால்வ்ட் இன் த ஹைபிரிடைசேஷன். ஸோ பேசிக்கலி சீனா, ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இன் ஐரன் ஓன்லி 4 வேக்கண்ட் ஆர்பிட்டல் இஸ் தேர், பட் 6 லிகான்ஸ் அப்ரோச்சிங் டு த சென்ட்ரல் மெட்டல் ஆட்டம், ரிக்வயர்ட் ஒன் மோர் 2 ஆர்பிட்டல். அப்போ என்ன ஆச்சு, இந்த 3D ஆர்பிட்டல் எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஆல்ரெடி அன்பேர்டு எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் இருக்குன்னா, தட் அன்பேர்டு எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஆர் இன்டர்மிக்ஸிங். இன்டர்மிக்ஸிங் மீன்ஸ் இட்ஸ் ஃபார்ம் வேக்கண்ட் ஆர்பிட்டல். திஸ் வேக்கண்ட் ஆர்பிட்டல் ஃப்ரம் டி ஆர்பிட்டல் 2, எஸ் ஆர்பிட்டல் 1, பி ஆர்பிட்டல் 3. திஸ் 3 1 ஆர் இன்டர்மிக்ஸிங், தட்ஸ் வை டி 2 எஸ் P3, D2SP3. So D2SP3, this completely 6 orbitals are intermixing, hence to form new hybrid orbital. This is called new hybrid orbital, is formed from D2SP3 hybridization. Already here 3 pairs are there. Apo ion involved in the D2SP3 hybridization to form, listen carefully, to form 6 new hybrid orbital. Appo enna aichuna, sira d2sp3 hybrid orbital of FeCN6 taken 4 minutes. Appo ready to arrange, iron is ready to arrange after hybridization 6 vacant orbital. In this 6 vacant orbital, each cyanide or each cyanide group donated 2 electrons. So now see here, this is a CN electron, all CN electron, each CN electron donated to 6 lone pair of electron to the central metal atom. Apo this D2SP3 orbitals are completely filled with cyanide electrons. This is cyanide 1 electron, cyanide 2, cyanide 3, cyanide 4, cyanide 5, cyanide 6 electrons completely filled. So ultimately now in this after ligands approaching to the central metal atom, after hybridization is completed, D2SP3 hybridization, now it satisfies the structure like this one. So in 3D orbital, 6 electrons are there, and D2SP3 hybrid orbital, this total 12 electrons are there. So this orbital name is the D2SP3. Hence this is the structure. So this is a central metal atom. This central metal atom providing total 6 vacant orbital. That vacant orbital name is a D2SP3 vacant orbital. Apo oru oru CN group is donated 2 electron, hence to completely filled with D2SP3 hybrid orbital, hence to form octahedral manner. This is the formation of octahedral complexes in hexacyanoferrate 2 ion. Clear ma? So first of all, this what is this presentation? definitely every student to write in examination point of view like this one. So first iron, first you will write iron atom final electronic configuration. Aparama, what is the oxidation state you will calculate it. In the oxidation state, what electrons are deleted also you deleted here. Aparama, how many ligands approaching to here, they are intermixing of orbital, finally this formation. Now from this compound, my dear students, after overlapping and bond formations of all the electrons present on the central Fe2 plus ion are paired. So now see here, there is no any unpaired electron after formation of the complexes. That's why FeCN6 taken 4 minus, FeCN6 taken 4 minus are diamagnetic substance. Already in as I said, if any one of the complex there is no any unpaired electron, that is obviously diamagnetic. So that's why FeCN6 4 minus is a diamagnetic. And what kind of hybridizations are there here? D2 sp3 hybridizations are there. That's why this is inner orbital complexes and low spin complexes. Okay ma'am, now I completed successfully formation of the first complexes. So remaining four examples are there. That four example I will teach in my next class. Okay na, I hope every student to easily to understand this concept. See carefully, if any one of the complex compound formed octahedral manner to show two different type of hybridization, d2 sp3, sp3 d2, d2 sp3 inner orbital complexes, sp3 d2 are the outer orbital complexes. Okay ma, good.